الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والله جعل لكم من بيوتكم سكنا، وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم، أفشوا السلام بينكم، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. In English we often hear people saying that home is where the heart is. Home is where the heart is. Seldom we'll hear a person saying house is where the heart is. The difference between the two is a house is a structure that is built with cement and bricks, but a home is a place that is built with love, affection, happiness and mutual understanding. We should ask ourselves a question: are we living in houses or are we living in homes? The answer to that is simple. We find in our house fighting, quarreling, no happiness in the house, always sadness, depression, tension, etc. A person always has the will and the zeal to go out of his house. He doesn't feel to enter his house. Then that person should understand that I'm not staying in a home, I'm staying in a house. And to make a house into a home is very simple. The prescription to that is to bring the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into our house. So I will elaborate on certain points today for which a person should think about. It's food for thought. He should try to bring it into his life. Because every person will not only stay in his business place, he will not only be walking in the mall during the entire day, but he will always return to his house. So the first point we should keep in mind, the first place that is food for thought is when we enter our home. How am I entering my house? Do I make salam when I enter my house? Do I enter my house with a happy and cheerful face? Or do I enter my house with sadness, with grief, with a purple face? Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala would often say that a true husband, a true man is a person who when he enters his home, he lives like a child. And when a matter has to rise up, then he shows himself to be a true man. To be a child means he should be happy, means he should be full of humor, means he should be cheerful when he enters his house. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha is asked, what was the condition of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he would enter the house? He says that kana rajulan min rijalikum. Just the way you are men, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was also a man, but the difference was, illa annahu kana dhahakan bassama. That when he would enter the home, he would always be smiling and he would always be cheerful. So when we enter our homes, we should enter while we are smiling. We should enter in the condition that we are cheerful and leave all sadness and happiness outside the doorstep of our houses. When we enter our house, the second thing we do is to make salam. When we make salam, we should make salam happily. Make salam with a cheerful and smiling face. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum once, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَابَبْتُمْ. Should I not tell you of something that if you have to bring it into your life, you will have love and affection between yourselves? And today it is also a sad reality. There is no happiness between the Muslims. Forget Muslim brothers, in Muslim homes there is no unity. This is one of the biggest reasons that there is no unity and love. No affection in the home. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Spread salam amongst yourselves and you will see that love growing day by day in the houses. And the third point that A person, when he enters his home, he should always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He should never forget to take the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith of Al-Rajjab ibn Abdullah radiallahu ta'ala an, he tells the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, that when a person enters his home, wa dhakar Allah, he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then shaitan himself, he says to his own self, and he tells all his companions, that today we do not have food to take part from. Today we do not have a place to sleep at, because this person remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he entered his home. On the contrary, when a person does not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaitan will say to himself, and he will tell all his followers and friends, that today we have found a place where we are going to eat from. Today we have found a place where we are going to spend our night.